Greetings, Aloy. I am known as Blameless Marad. Please come with me. You're needed for an important consultation.
What do you mean? Where's Erend?
He's inside, attending the Sun King, where we should be without further delay. Follow me, please.
All of these people are here to see the Sun King.
Impressionist.
Yes, and each has come to ask a favor of him. Unpleasant, but that's politics. The Sun King is eager to meet you, the machine tamer with a curious eye for detail. It's all very intriguing.
I'm not here to intrigue you.
Too late.
First the Oseram gets special treatment, and now Outlanders and Savage Beasts.
By
talking so much
woman,
shit, you guys really accept. Don't whisper, you just say it out loud.
I believe two owls in this Nord go to the front of the line.
That is correct.
Ignore them. Nobles are like children who whine when they don't get a second helping of
dessert. Where did they find this voice actor? Fucking Morgan Freeman's little brother
or
something.
What's the Sun King like?
The most important thing is what he isn't like. His father. I think you'll find him to be a reasonable man.
Aloy of the Nora. She who sees the unseen. Welcome. It would seem you have done me a great service. Erend, tell her what you found.
I checked Ursa's tomb. You were right, Aloy. The body is missing a scar below her right knee. I gave it to Ursa when we were kids, fighting over a Tor sword.
If the body is not Ursa's, then we must assume she is still alive.
She's still alive.
And I will not abandon her.
We only know she was taken, not who took her.
I can help with that. Ursa has an enemy among the Oseram. A warlord named Dervahl.
Impossible. Every clan in the claim has been hunting for him since the liberation. He has to be dead by now.
No other Oseram had the motive and ingenuity to lure Ursa into this trap. I expect to find him lurking somewhere near the border. I've already sent an agent to investigate.
He'll be
waiting for word from us at the marketplace in Pitchcliff.
I can't move troops to the border without provoking the Oseram. But I could send a few vanguardsmen. And perhaps an exceptionally gifted Nora as well. Erend, Marad, let me discuss it with her privately. I hate to impose further after all you've done, but this is a matter of great importance to me.
It sounds like Ursa means a lot to you.
Without her Oseram vanguard, I would not have been able to liberate Meridian and end my father's brutal reign. Since then, it has been difficult to maintain peace between our tribes. But Ursa has a way of making her people see reason. So you see, I need her back at my side. And quickly.
Who is Dervahl exactly?
To understand Dervahl, you must first understand my father. He truly thought of himself as a sun god. His mind was broken.
Broken.
He believed that blood sacrifice would solve, well, everything. So he raided the other tribes for victims, especially the Oseram. Dervahl fought back. He crafted powerful weapons and rallied his people. My father responded with the ultimate cruelty.
What is the ultimate cruelty?
He captured Dervahl's wife and daughter.
Oh, yeah.
And sacrificed them in the Sun Ring.
So, why would Dervahl go to so much trouble to kidnap Ursa?
He felt she betrayed him. She fought by his side until she realized he planned to raise Meridian and butcher its people. And she came to me. Together, we stopped him and liberated the city from my father. Dervahl has spent every moment since trying to get revenge. Mostly on the other Oseram who fought with us. He made so many powerful enemies. I thought we'd seen the last of him. I was wrong.
Okay, I don't care about that.
I need to get going.
I know. Well, they say kings should never beg. But please, help me find Ursa.
Who says that?
Well, Murad, for one. Don't hesitate to ask him or Erend if you have further questions.
This would be much funnier if your voice is actually recorded in this session.
This must be Pitchcliff. Murad's agent should be at the marketplace by now.
No sign of Murad's guy. He's had plenty of time to investigate.
We'd better look for him.
Damn right.
Well, someone left here recently, and they were in a hurry.
Oh shit. Just wanna beat the living daylight out of him.
Has to be Murad's guy. Durval's thugs must have made him.
Maybe because he found something. Look at this. I think he drew a map with his own blood.
Right. Those kind of maps you know you'd better follow.
That might be Pitchcliff. He marked a spot to the north. Could be Durval's location.
Well, my men are waiting outside of town. I'll grab them and meet you there.
Well. And we are here. Child. Just phased right through the horse.
Chained up.
Durval's a tinker. He probably experiments on them or strips them for parts.
Maybe I can use them to make some trouble. I'll go in first. Hold off until the fighting starts.
All right. We've got your back.
Machine!
He took one directly to himself, don't tell me. Kill me, dick.
Durval's men. It's about to get ugly.
I hope.
Shitting me. Died twice.
Involves men. It's about to get ugly.
How did these fuckers not die? My headshot. come back for those. Jesus. That's like a lot more than I expected, especially for this one. Time to pick up all the pieces and then we return.
Val says you gotta eat dirt.
Well, there's the dirt. Now what? What is he wearing? Earplugs? You can't see her white face and red hair. Oh shit.
What is they this, a boss called battle? On the Vanguard for this.
That did nothing to him.
Here's a shot.
One more should do it. last time.
Ursa must be in there. We have to get through.
He's just tickled in his ears.
They must use these to protect themselves from that awful sound.
So that only means I can go in there. We'll take this. Times. He kept her pinned down.
Aaron? Durval tried to break me. Shows what he knows.
I should have been with you. Why didn't you come for me? I know I'm a useless trunk, but...
No, idiot. I got a message from Durval saying he wanted to parlay. I didn't come for you because I knew it was a trap. I couldn't let you get hurt. Just didn't think it'd be that good a trap. Thought I could take him out. No. Now listen. Durval's planning something big in Meridian. He said he'd force Avad to watch as the smoke darkens their precious sun. Your king needs you. No more playing around. You're gonna have to grow up fast.
I will. I promise.
You damn well better, little boy.
Ursa. No, no. Please. I won't let you down. I promise.
I'm so sorry.
You've got to find Durval. But Meridian's a big place.
I'll look through his things. Maybe we can narrow it down. Strange device. It's beautifully crafted. What happens when I turn it on?
I think I've got it working. There. Now, say something. Both of you, Doves.
I don't know. What do you want me to say?
Whatever you want. I just want to hear your voice and keep it for later.
I'll sing, Papa. La 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 la.
There. A song and a laugh. Even better than words. And now I can hear them whenever I want.
We're done, then? Off to bed with you.
Good night, Mama. Good night, Papa.
Is she gone? What are we going to do? The raids are getting closer and closer to Main Spring. How much longer can we hide like this?
A keepsake from his family. Just notes about crafting. And a letter tucked between the pages. Lots of blaze. Headed to Meridian.
Don't think I'll read that. What did we get? I got a shit ton of stuff, didn't I? Nothing. Craft. I can't even craft shit for my outfit. I need more.
If we find it, I'll bet we find Durval too.
There's something else.
Okay. What's Durval learned from all his tinkering? Do I even want to know? I think I found something that can help. Let's head back to the palace.
Go. I won't be long, but I need to tend to my sister.
Sun shall fall. I still have not gone to this fucking area. Okay, well, we've done this enough. His quest line. Now I need to go here because I really want to see what we find. What the hell is it? Where?
Killing machine that disappears into thin air.
What the? What the hell are those?
Thank you.
get up the goddamn rock.
That machine looks like it could carry a mountain. Rumor says it's all through one.
Oh no, my horse is being attacked. I'm getting in here one way or another.
Just stay out of their way for now.
Ow.
Get on with it.
Either way, I'm gonna have to clear it out, so I need to use stronger arrows.
Still surprised.
The double arrows usually work.
Stocking up.
Big trouble.
Great. Oh my fucking God. Guy's got some maneuvers. Oh, I can't even talk. I'm just concentrating too damn hard.
Pandy? The bandits imprisoned these people. The eclipse and corrupted machines cooperating.
Can't scavenge it until that stuff is gone. There you go.
Got their attention.
Thank you.
do it past 2 years just to get through.
Snow haze. White as bone.
That thought got dark.
All these ruins. What do the old ones do here?
Introduced.
Still good, we're still hitting. I know what I'm doing. I haven't died here, I haven't done this, but I know
dead,
what I'm
but
doing.
Not long. Watch out. This is not place for a soldier. I'll rope burn a frost black, chopping it hard.
There's someone right there. Exactly what I'm gonna find out.
With them fighting at our side, Meridian will be ours once more.
Not tripping, aren't I? Who's man's voice that I hear? There's no one else here but me, so I don't know why I heard someone else's voice. How we take that thing down, yeah, we just avoid it. like, at all costs.
A corruptor. That might prove a challenge.
Not really. If I do one of these, and then go direct the path over there. Probably one of those. Right over there, so I can get this. And that's how you get past them. Gotta be very, very careful. Collect shit while I'm here too.
Disabled his focus. The rest is up to you.
I'll handle it. Steam's blasting out. I wonder if those are weak points.
Come out of the shadows.
What the hell? Oh, that was a weak point. Took him down to no health at all.
Thank you.
That thing really hurt it.
Up this last mission and probably go to bed.
It's tight, but I can squeeze through.
Hold for identity scan. Please proceed to the 35th
floor. Wait, kept counting.
350,000. That's hundreds of years ago. What's going on?
You are this late for your meeting. Ow! Well, thanks for telling me. I can jump off the edge. So where do I go? Well, hold on, you don't expect me to not pass everything up in here.
But the protocols use polyphasic entangled waveforms, quantum encryption, black quartz stuff, way beyond military grade. That's what you demanded. So that's what we delivered.
You don't code something you can't crack. All we need is a backdoor. Upload the latest service pack update and the problem goes away.
You specifically forbade us from leaving anything resembling a backdoor in code. Every protocol to Black Quartz standard. Your words. Look, if you need me to fudge some projections, it's nothing we haven't done before.
I don't need fudged projections. I need a way to reassert control over the Hearts Timor Swarm.
I don't know what to tell you, Ted. You're asking the impossible.
So, codes. They needed codes of some kind to control the machines. But they got out of control. Sounds bad.
Maybe. Well, hang on, what the hell is here then? Okay, that was weird. Got to explore every inch of this place. In here.
Oh. A death warrior. Or a statue of one, anyway.
A machine built to kill. And they ordered it?
Welcome to Feral Automated Solutions, where all the problems of tomorrow are faced in nations and corporate holdings.
What was this place? What were they doing here?
It was a corporation. A group of people, not unlike a tribe. And they made machines.
Yeah, go on.
I've uploaded some data files to your focus. They'll help you understand.
I don't really want to read, so... yeah. Good. All I know is that they built machines, they tried to control them, and they failed. Sounds a little like Terminator, but, yeah. I would only listen to it if it's...
Now, I know this must seem like a bizarre change in direction. I mean, we're Feral Automated Solutions, right? Number one robotics firm in the world. Why would we clear our production slate to fabricate human-operated vehicles and weapon systems, the relics of the past? All I can say at this juncture is... trust me, we will be exploiting a massive, growth opportunity by retooling and reallocating capacity according to my plan. So I will need revised projections of mass fabrication velocity across every pipeline within 36 hours.
So they were making machines, then they stopped. With other kinds of weapons? Why? Haven. But I could get through.
Don't tell me I have to walk all the way back. What the hell? That scared me. What the hell? Anyways, like I was saying, don't tell me I have to climb all the way back out of this room just to get the hell out.
Looks like I can climb here.
Jump over there, you stupid fuck. Well, I guess can't go back. She doesn't know how to go back.
They blamed this place for something. Something bad.
The ACA-3 Scarab combines conventional and information warfare capabilities in one package. Designed for high-speed, all-terrain reconnaissance. It boasts the world's highest survivability rating of any Scout-class autonomous agent. Maybe it's the Scarab's emergency biomass conversion systems that ensure it always makes it back to base, even if fuel supply lines have been interdicted. Or maybe it's the Scarab's ability to slave enemy robots to its own network. Now that's force multiplication. Add a prehensile manipulator arm that can handle a host of functions. from 360-degree less lethal riot management to surgical repairs of Allied chariot line models. And you've got the workhorse of any cutting-edge peacekeeping fleet.
The Corruptor. Slave enemy robots to its own network. It sounds like it's talking about how it corrupts machines.
Whoa, how can it be top of the line? I could beat it with a bow and arrow.
The BOR-7 Horus. Imagine your complete engagement ecosystem comprehensively managed by a high-speed learning machine network. Whether your need is to replace battlefield losses or intensify force projection, the Horus's onboard manufacturing capabilities mean you'll never get stuck waiting for the next arms delivery. Simply redefine your force parameters, and the Horus will fabricate additional units to fill the ranks for an affordable per-unit licensing fee. Meanwhile, the biomass conversion systems of other chariot line models allow them to keep the Horus fueled, repaired, and ready, extending its operational tolerances beyond that of any competing Titan-class platform. That's the Horus advantage. Always regulating, always ready. The future of automated warfare made real today.
The Metal Devil. So these were Faro machines too.
I think I met the Metal Devil.
Capabilities. They can make more of themselves. Then how would you ever stop them?
The FSP-5 Kopesh provides a one-size-fits-all solution to main battle force capability. Metamaterial construction delivers unmatched recoil dampening, allowing you to field any weapon package that conforms to your budget needs and conflict resolution profile. Patented biomass conversion systems allow extended emergency operations with minimal environmental impact. Multilinear target processing provides simultaneous real-time threat analysis and legal review for autonomous domestic operations. Or control can be slaved to the swarm's neural network for weapons-free force application. Either way, when it's time to call out the big guns, it's time to call Kopesh.
The Deathbringer. So this was the heavy hitter. Main battle force indeed.
Well, they were so sure of themselves that the robots couldn't be beaten, they get beaten by arrows and sticks.
It'll be a long way up. Frozen metal most of the way. Not making this easy, Dr. Sobek. If plants can find a way to hang on up here, guess I can too.
Oh yeah, what's this way then? Whew. Are there two ways up? I guess so. Something up this way. Nope, it appears to be the same way. It's just a shortcut, I guess.
This is the began when they engaged in unauthorized offensive operations against robots and human personnel of the Hearts Timor Energy Combine. Now I wish that I could relate that the crisis has been exaggerated, but it's not. The peacekeepers have not responded to stand down codes, and by all signs, they appear to be replicating at a precipitous rate. Now what I can promise, can absolutely assure you, is that I am already devoting every possible resource towards reaching a speedy conclusion to this issue. So when you hear the bad talk about us, against this company, in the days, maybe weeks to come, just bear in mind that we will get past this. And the day's coming when none of this will matter.
Peacekeepers. That's what they called their machines. They were built for war, not peace.
course. How do you get machines? Boy. I can never know. What the? Oh, almost fell.
It's cold.
Why does she miss her jump? Every time, no matter what it is, she'll miss her first jump. Please, thank you. This health. Is there gonna be a boss battle? Ring.
Way up. All it takes is a few good handholds. All right, made it. Wonder what we'll find.
From this device. Do you wish to deploy Alpha privileges to recover purge data?
Oh yes, I believe I do.
A file has been recovered.
One file.
Elizabeth, good to, it's been years.
Where's your legal team, Ted?
No need. I dropped all 18 lawsuits the moment you landed. I assume your data confirms this.
All right, this promises to be interesting.
Perhaps we could have lunch brought in. You know, get reacquainted.
I know you, Ted. You've screwed something up, something big, or you wouldn't have eaten the crow necessary to get me here. So spit it out.
There's a glitch in the chariot line.
Your killer robots?
Peacekeepers, yes. Those.
So shut them down.
Obviously, Liz, we would, if we could. They're not responding.
Are you telling me a swarm has gone rogue, Ted?
It's worse than that.
Show me the data, then. And I'll take that lunch. Alone.
Huh.
Ted Faro brought Elizabeth Sobek here. But they hated each other.
Another file has been recovered.
This isn't a glitch. It's a catastrophe.
Fully aware. It's bad.
Bad?
Jesus, Liz.
It's not bad, Ted. It's apocalyptic. You built a line of killer robots.
Peacekeepers.
That consume biomass as fuel.
In emergencies.
And you made them capable of self-replication.
Limited self-manufacture controlled.
Not anymore. The glitch severed chain of command. The only nation this swarm answers to now is itself.
You think I did?
Everything else is just food. And at the rate it's replicating, Ted, it will strip the Earth bare in 15 months. We're not talking fall of civilization. We're talking extinction.
I get it, Liz. So how do I stop it while it's contained?
It's not contained. It can't be.
You know what I mean.
Right. Before the truth gets out, you mean.
Liz, I will do anything you say. Keep working it, and whatever you recommend, I'll do.
I'm gonna hold you to that, Ted.
The Faro robots threatened all life on Earth. But somehow she defeated them. The world of the old ones fell, but life went on, or we wouldn't be here.
A final Faro has been recovered.
Project Zero Dawn.
Zero Dawn.
Jesus, Liz. There has to be another way.
If there were a nicer way to fix your mess, I would have proposed it.
But this? This? When I asked you to find a cure, I didn't expect it to be worse than the disease.
It's not, Ted. It may be grim, but it's our only chance. Now sign the proposal.
Sign it? I can't sign that.
Yes, you can.
That? Liz, I cannot in good conscience sign that.
You've got a choice, Ted.
I know.
I'm speaking to you from a VTOL en route to U.S. Robot Command. In 15 minutes, I meet with General Harris and the rest of the Joint Chiefs.
What? Are you crazy?
Now your choice is what I tell them. Sign, and I'll tell them the wealthiest corporation on Earth has guaranteed the funds necessary to build Zero Dawn. Exactly as I've designed it. Or don't sign, and I will make sure they and everyone else on this planet knows the real cause of the glitch.
Jesus, Liz. You don't have to threaten me. I'll sign.
Look on the bright side, Ted. From here on out, you get to do what you've always been good at. Footing the bill while others get their hands dirty.
God forgive me.
Made her solution so terrible. What did she do to stop the robots?
Executive access detected. Express lift opened.
Express lift?
This doesn't add up. Sobek couldn't have been my mother. She lived ages ago. All this searching, and I'm still no closer.
That's your reaction to everything you've just learned? To whine like a spoiled child?
You should really try talking that way to me face to face.
As you wish. Do you really have no idea how monumental are the discoveries you just made, Aloy? I expected more of you.
So, you have a face. Got a name to go with it?
Of all the questions you could ask right now, that's the one you choose.
A name.
I've spent decades searching the ruins of the old ones, trying to solve the mystery of what happened to them. For years, I've suspected that Faro robots destroyed their civilization, but I could never confirm it. And in minutes, you uncover more ancient knowledge than I have in a lifetime, and what you want to know is my name.
Mm-hmm.
Silence, that's my name. Now, why don't you try asking another question? Something less trivial.
You have no idea what I've been through. How hard it's been. My whole life, I grew up not knowing who I am or where I came from, and then come the Eclipse trying to kill me just because I look like this Elizabeth Sobek woman.
And they killed the man who raised you and you found in the mountain as a baby. I already know this through your focus.
The point is, every time I take a step forward, the answers slip farther from my grasp. You just don't understand.
It's not that I don't understand, Aloy. It's that I don't care. If the answers keep slipping away every step you take, then you best start running to catch up. Maybe then you'll realize just how big your problems really are.
What exactly are you talking about?
You've chased a personal riddle into a crowd of larger mysteries. The common thread is your connection to Elizabeth Subic.
But what is that connection? She couldn't have been my mother if she lived centuries ago.
We don't know the connection yet. The only way to find out is to keep going, to keep making discoveries. Thanks to you, we've only just now learned that Pharaoh robots once threatened to end life on Earth.
But it didn't happen. The Old One's civilization was destroyed, but life was saved.
Obviously. So, what did Elizabeth do? How did she stop the robots before all was lost?
What was Project Zero Dawn?
Exactly the question. Now, are you ready to go get the answer?
Of course I am.
Then why are you still standing here?
You're insufferable, you know that? Let's get on with this. Elizabeth told Ted Faro she was headed for a place called U.S. Robot Command to tell people about Zero Dawn.
The place still exists as a ruin. The Asaram call it the Grave Horde.
Grave Horde? Cheery name.
You'll find it in the Eastern Mountains, buried under the tangled coils of a metal devil, or a BOR-7 Horus, rather, as we're learning to call them. I'll contact you when you get there.
I can't wait. Someday we'll meet in person, and your manners had better be improved.
Yeah. Alright,
well, getting down will be a lot faster than getting up here, at least.
Let's jump
US
down.
US Robot Command next. To learn the secrets of Zero Dawn.
Let's jump down and end this episode.